everyone. It's great to be here as a part of the Azure Hybrid event. I'm Jeremy Winter, Vice President for Azure Arc and Azure Management. And you've heard from my colleagues, Roanne, Corey, Asad, and Gabe, talk about different aspects of Azure Hybrid and our focus to give you a comprehensive solution that meets you wherever you are. Now, I'm here today to cover the key value that you can get from Azure Arc to govern and secure your infrastructure, such as servers, Kubernetes clusters, and services deployed anywhere. To quickly recap, Azure is built for hybrid at its core, and Azure Arc is a key component of Microsoft's hybrid and multi-cloud platform that seamlessly extends the capabilities of Azure to on-prem data centers, edge locations, and any other public cloud. Customers on Azure can centrally operate, govern, and secure infrastructure running in diverse environments. In this session, we're going to focus in on the single control plane, which enables consistent operations, automation, and security, and how you can start leveraging the same skill sets you are building with Azure in other environments. We also know security and governance is top of mind for you. We'll look at how you can work with Microsoft as a trusted security partner, leveraging our investments in security in your environments. Let's look at how your environments are evolving. The advances in cloud and edge technologies are enabling organizations to reinvent and scale their businesses in ways that we could have only imagined just a few years ago. You may have had investments in hundreds or even thousands of applications to meet your business needs. Yet these applications are distributed across multiple data centers, branch offices, edge locations, and cloud platforms. Now, when I talk to customers, often the questions I get are, how do you govern diverse and distributed environments? How do you ensure security across the entire organization? And how do you do this in a way that all operations are consistent? Now, with Azure and Azure Arc, we are helping you establish a consistent way to govern, secure, and operate all of these environments, enabling developers to build applications once and then deploy and run them in the same way anywhere. Azure Arc helps our customers unify operations and management, a key first step to being successful at scaling with a hybrid and multi-cloud strategy. Azure Arc is really an extension of what we're doing in Azure. We've always taken an approach that we must manage a wide range of resources. We understand that it's not enough to have a point solution for one kind of resource at a time. Whether it's just servers, just containers, or just apps, the reality is that it's all of these that we need to manage. Security is a priority area we've made a ton of investments in to protect our customers running in Azure. We understand that security is even more top of mind for our customers with diverse and distributed environments. This is why we are bringing the security investments we've made native in Azure to the hybrid space. And lastly, the ultimate outcome of a consistent platform approach with Azure Arc is that you and your team's skill sets become transferable. Whether you're working on-prem or in any of the public clouds, whether you're working on traditional three-tiered applications or you're building a new microservice architected application to run on Kubernetes, these common set of Azure services and tools can be standard across all those different scenarios. But before we get any deeper here, I think it'd be great to show you Azure Arc in action. So I'm going to hand it over to Ryan Willis, a member of my engineering team, to give us a tour for just how easy it is to get up and running across a variety of resources and environments. Ryan, welcome. Hey, can you give us a run through on Azure Arc?
Thanks, Jeremy. Let's head over to the Azure portal and see how Tailwind Traders is using Azure Arc to unify their operations. Tailwind Traders is a retail organization with workloads in multiple clouds, data centers, and retail stores. Like many organizations, they have a mix of legacy applications running on Windows, Linux, and SQL servers, and all their new applications are being containerized to run on Kubernetes in the cloud. The servers in Kubernetes cluster you see on the screen here are running outside of Azure, but they show up and can be managed from Azure thanks to Azure Arc. So I'll open up one of these Kubernetes clusters, and we'll see that it's modeled just like any other Azure resource. They belong to resource groups and subscriptions and can be tagged with metadata to help you organize and find related resources. Azure Arc also makes it easy to enroll this Kubernetes cluster in other Azure management, monitoring, and security services. So for instance, if I want to start collecting performance and log information for my cluster, I can go to the Azure Monitor Insights tab and specify the workspace where I want to store the data in Azure. The Arc agent running on that Kubernetes cluster will take care of installing and configuring the monitoring tools for me. I don't have to mess around with copying scripts or even be on the same network as my cluster to start collecting these logs and metrics. The same approach works for Windows and Linux servers too. And it's all possible because of that Azure control plane that Jeremy had mentioned earlier. The control plane gives a consistent inventory and management experience for all of your resources, no matter where they may be running. It's also the foundation for governance with Azure Policy. So Azure Policy allows you to set guardrails for Azure resources and monitor compliance over time to minimize risk and simplify audits. Azure Arc extends policy to your servers and Kubernetes clusters running outside of Azure, so you can have a single pane of glass for compliance across all of your environments. So let's drill deeper and take a look at compliance across our resources. Here we can see a list of all the policies assigned to our subscription and the latest compliance status. This status is updated and reevaluated regularly to catch any changes in the configuration of your machines. So remember earlier when I enabled monitoring on that Kubernetes cluster? Policy can help automate that for you as well. Let's look at the Enable Azure Monitor for VMs policy. This policy checks Azure VMs and Arc-enabled servers to see if the monitoring agents are installed. When that server is connected to Azure Arc for the first time, policy will automatically deploy any monitoring tools required to that server. But if for some reason the monitoring tools are removed later on, the IT admins can create a remediation task to reinstall the agent on all the non-compliant machines. And this gives you a zero-touch configuration experience that works at scale with built-in reporting. Tailwind Traders is also using Security Center to get a complete picture of their security posture across all their resources. When we open Security Center, we can see a quick summary of how we're doing across a variety of security controls and recommendations. Security Center can help with your next audit with pre-built policies to audit operating system and resource configurations against common regulatory standards. Security Center takes the audit data from Azure Policy and maps it to the appropriate controls in the standards so that you don't have to do any guesswork. Let's take a look at the inventory of resources that Azure Security Center is monitoring. So just like with our other services, Security Center integrates with the control plane and is comparing the inventory of known resources against the security data that it's collected about them. For each resource, we can see whether they're fully protected and how many recommendations are available for that resource. If we click an on-premises SQL server, for example, we can see that there are several findings for our server. In the recommendation details, we can see that our on-premises database has several vulnerabilities that can be addressed to improve the security posture of our environment. Each security check is annotated with a severity level and the benchmarks to which it's applicable, making it easy to understand the potential impact of each recommendation. And so everything I just showed is just scratching the surface of the possible integrations you get when you connect your hybrid and multi-cloud servers to Azure with Azure Arc. I'll toss this back to Jeremy to tell you more about how this all works.
Thanks, Ryan. That was great, and I appreciate your time. So simple, yet powerful. So all right, let's dive into where we see customers like yourself really taking advantage of this. When it comes to managing that wide range of resources, Ryan showed how he can operate them in a single place. A single agent install makes it easy to onboard all these resources to Azure, including physical, virtual Windows, Linux, SQL Server, and Kubernetes clusters. Once resources are onboarded by communicating through the control plane, you're able to use the same capabilities Azure provides for your cloud resources on your resources outside of Azure. So once we get everything into that control plane, it becomes simple and easy to manage, automate, and rationalize these new IT investments. Azure Arc gives you that truly single pane of glass experience so you can unify all your operations under one roof. Let's take a deeper look here. For Azure native resources, we provide a wide range of solutions for operations and security, which are also available for resources connected with Arc. Customers are using them with existing traditional applications as well as new cloud native apps. Azure Monitor is a great example of one of these. Once a resource is Arc enabled, you can just turn on Azure Monitor and immediately begin to collect, analyze, and act on telemetry data from resources connected through Arc running anywhere. Azure Monitor helps you maximize performance and availability of your applications and proactively identify problems in seconds. Now, Azure Lighthouse helps make multi-tenant self-service and delegated access control easier. With it, you can keep full transparency into user actions and manage multi-tenant access without compromising security. You can easily decide who can access your estate, what they can access, and when. Now with Arc, you can use Lighthouse not only in Azure, but anywhere on the edge or other clouds. This is a powerful concept for multi-tenant needs or enabling managed service providers, again with Azure constructs extended to your other environments. Now, Azure Arc is a platform for an entire ecosystem. You get a choice of the tools and systems you need to work with. We understand flexibility is important, especially where you already invested. Azure Arc supports Windows Server and a wide range of Linux operating systems, such as SUSE and Red Hat. You can manage SQL Server on Arc-enabled servers, so in addition to the governance and inventory benefits, you are able to take advantage of SQL-specific security services or proactive SQL Server assessments, ensuring your databases are optimally tuned. Azure Arc-enabled Kubernetes meets you where you are with your existing Kubernetes investments. Any CNCF-conformant Kubernetes can host the Azure Arc agent and gain the benefits of the cloud-based management. In addition to the broad support, we have a set of validated partners, including OpenShift, Rancher, Tanzu, and Carbon. Azure Arc-enabled Kubernetes is also integrated with Microsoft first-party offering, AKS on Azure Stack HCI, giving you lots of options for where and how you adopt Kubernetes. And you saw earlier, we're working across many different Azure services, data services, application services, even machine learning, to enable them with Azure Arc so that they can run anywhere just like they do on Azure. Okay, on to the next area I see customers utilizing Azure Arc. Governance and compliance. You know, governance and compliance is a critical aspect of being successful with the cloud operating model and another capability that we've deeply built into Azure. With Azure's policy capabilities, you set the guardrails, which help you audit and enforce resource configurations across Azure in a scalable manner. Through Azure Arc, hybrid resources are integrated into the native policy engine that runs from within Azure. Azure Policy will continually check on the compliance and regulatory state of your systems without you having to string together a bunch of custom scripts. So with Azure Arc and Policy, you can govern the environment and ensure resources are compliant with your operating practices in a consistent and repeatable way, regardless where you are running those applications. Now, in addition to governance and compliance, Azure also provides a secure foundation to strengthen your security posture. At Microsoft, we invest more than $1 billion a year in cybersecurity and have over 3,500 global security experts monitoring and securing Azure. We also analyze trillions of signals from Microsoft services such as Windows and Xbox around the globe to identify new and evolving threats. The insights we've gained in cybersecurity have formed the way we build Azure security tools to protect our customers' workloads. But we also want to take action. We want to help you see and stop threats before they cause harm so that you can feel good about the global coverage across your entire estate. Azure Arc works with our security products to help make it easier to build next-generation security operations across the data centers, edge, and multi-cloud. Let's first talk about how you can ensure that your cloud infrastructure is configured in a secure manner at any point in time. The first one is Azure Security Center. Continuously assesses the security state of your cloud resources across virtual machines, networks, apps, and data services. Its multi-cloud capabilities help you visualize your security state and quickly get insights on your configured security controls. The second is Azure Defender, which provides a competitive cloud-native extended detection and response solution for Windows and Linux servers, containers, and serverless workloads that Azure and hybrid customers have widely adopted. Azure Defender benefits from the Microsoft Intelligence Security Graph, which uses those trillions of signals I mentioned before from Microsoft services. And this really helps us protect and think about systems around the globe to identify new and evolving threats. And finally, everything comes together with Azure Sentinel. Azure Sentinel makes it easy to collect security data across your entire hybrid organization, from devices, users, apps, servers, and any cloud. Azure Sentinel uses the power of AI to help you quickly identify real threats and releases you from the burden of traditional SIEMs by eliminating the need to spend time on setting up, maintaining, and scaling that infrastructure. All of these are capabilities that you can simply just turn on if you've onboarded with Azure Arc. In fact, what we're seeing is that security scenarios are one of those top reasons customers are using Azure Arc with their existing Windows and Linux servers that they're managing today. Now, we're seeing great momentum with thousands of customers using and building solutions with our hybrid capabilities today. What's amazing is how so many of these customers are using them in vast and different scenarios. Many customers are, like I just said, starting with global security coverage for their IT estate. Others, like Gabe talked about in the previous session, are building new cloud-native applications anywhere with both Kubernetes and Azure services. Many customers are also looking to accelerate their cloud adoption and migration initiatives here. They want to start adopting cloud practices and technologies on-prem with workloads that aren't ready to be migrated to the public cloud. They want to be able to build cloud skills and processes so that when they move, they're ready to go. One of the customers that I think it would be great to tell you about is actually a partner of ours, Avanade. Now, Avanade is using Azure Arc to accelerate cloud adoption decisions, simplify and standardize their infrastructure management, while thinking about reducing costs and ensuring regulatory compliance. For many of their customers, a cloud migration is something that takes time, and not every workload can move to the public cloud. While they are preparing to move, Azure Arc enables Avanade to connect environments and start utilizing the Azure services. The skills and processes they develop carry forward when they are migrating to Azure, and are consistent with the skills and processes for the resources that remain on-prem. Beyond migration, Azure Arc is enabling Avanade to support portability utilizing Kubernetes-based applications. One Avanade customer, for example, has a SaaS offering for financial services companies worldwide. When regulations require software and data to remain in a specific country, the company has to manage and run that part of the solution very differently. As we talked about throughout the session, Avanade and their customer have turned to Azure Arc to manage everything for consistency and governance controls, regardless of which country or environment the solution needs to run within. All right, as we wrap this section up, I want to thank you all for joining me. A few things to keep in mind. First, remember that bringing everything into a single set of management tools is more than just a superficial view. It's a path to build transferable skills to work on critical and strategic initiatives. Second, our goal is to help you have peace of mind with operations and compliance, and they are more important than ever in a hybrid and multi-cloud world. The technologies in Azure can help you make progress with the new cloud model. And finally, we're going to continue to have security at the forefront of our priorities as the world becomes more and more reliant on technology. We will continue to be with you as you safeguard your data, infrastructure, and your entire estate.